Prisons are usually challenging places meant for punishment, right? But imagine if, instead of a hard time, some prisoners were kicking back like they're on holiday. In this video, we will share some jaw-dropping stories about prisoners in Ecuador who turned their cells into luxury suites. Stick around as we reveal who's behind all this and how they made it happen. There's been a wild discovery in Ecuador, where many families barely scrape by to get three meals on the table. Can you believe some prisoners were living it up with fancy stuff like a self-made swimming pool in the prison yard? Yeah, it's a place to chill and beat the heat inside their prison. In Ecuador, prisoners were provided with shelter and food and even enjoyed a pool, all funded by the taxes of law-abiding Ecuadorians. The inmates freely filled the courtyard with water and even indulged in diving, and what's more, they had a private jacuzzi reserved exclusively for the cell block leaders. This scenario was replicated across all prisons, where inmates had access to barbershops, massage parlors, and gym equipment to stay fit. The prisons were akin to luxury hotels, complete with double beds, recessed lighting, televisions, and even a nightclub equipped with LED lights where alcoholic beverages were sold as if it were a corner store. The jails were stocked with all sorts of products and drinks. Just look at the incredible number of bottles they stored in their cells, a complete liquor store at their disposal. And hold on, it gets crazier. The guards found a nightclub inside the prison that could give your local hangout spot a run for its money. We're talking about a cell decked out with color-changing LED lights, setting the mood for the inmates. They turned their cell into a party spot where guys could hang out with female visitors or escorts. Can you even imagine that in the US justice system? A nightclub with pulsating music to forget their worries? Well, this wasn't enough comfort for the prisoners, cause further inspection revealed jacuzzis where the prisoners could take luxury baths. A luxury bath, nightclubs, and swimming pools? These guys were being rewarded for their crimes. But there's more to this wild story. Picture this. The prisoners' cells aren't just cells. They're more like rooms in a fancy hotel. We're talking double beds, TVs for those lazy afternoons. And get this, there's even a shop selling booze right inside the prison. Can you believe they turned a corner of the jail into a mini mart for alcohol and illicit drugs? And we're not just talking about a few hidden bottles here and there. These guys' stash could easily stock up three big liquor stores on the outside. But that's not where it stops. Life in this place has become so chill that some inmates are even hosting visitors from the outside, just like they're at some twisted, locked-up bed and breakfast. The amount of luxury the prisoners enjoy extends beyond the normal levels of comfort. The prisoners also have access to television antennas, modems for internet access, and even a tilapia farm for fresh fish. You've got to be kidding. These guys literally eat grilled fish for breakfast. What happened to the soup bowls and the small portions of beans prisoners often eat on TV shows? Is prison life the same as it used to be? Do we still have a structured legal system? Such amenities starkly contrast to the poor conditions endured by law-abiding citizens outside the prison walls. The recent renovations of prison cells by prisoners show a blatant disregard for authority. The raid conducted by Ecuadorian security forces unearthed a treasure trove of contraband, further revealing the extent of the illegal activities occurring within the prison's walls. Premium liquor bottles lined the shelves, alongside designer clothing and expensive watches. Drugs were also readily accessible to inmates, fueling a culture of violence and indulgence. While searching for contraband and phones, the authorities discovered that the prisoners were making use of the workshops to hide contraband. Phone spaces were carved out of wood, which was then used to smuggle phones back to prison cells. They also discovered guns hidden on the roof of the holding facility, among other contrabands. Challenges persist despite efforts to maintain order, including burning luxury items and implementing strict security measures. Weapons buried in prison gardens and other illegal substances concealed on rooftops continue to pose a threat to safety and security. As authorities meticulously documented their findings, one inmate revealed how excited he was after the raid because things were finally returning to normal. The other inmates were paying the guards to enjoy a lavish lifestyle. However, he couldn't afford it and had gone green with envy whenever he noticed his peers enjoying sweet delicacies, among other things. Paying for exotic food is one thing, but turning a prison into a luxury hotel? One has got to wonder how these guys are doing it. Is the security system so weak and corrupt that prisoners no longer fear the authorities? Rumor has it that there's more to the ongoing crisis than meets the eye. Jose Macias Villamar, Fito, one of the most significant drug lords in Ecuador, is one of the criminals in the prison who helped convert the prison and cells into a type of five-star inmate spa and resort that offered total luxury and impunity behind bars. Jose Macias Villamar, popularly known as Fito, is the leader of the Choneros. For 25 years, Los Choneros has been a significant part of Ecuador's criminal landscape, boasting at least 12,000 members. However, recent reports suggest they're losing ground to their rivals, Los Lobos. The situation escalated when Fito, the leader of Los Choneros, and the head of Los Lobos both escaped from prison, leading to a group of criminals seizing control of the TC television channel and threatening staff with weapons and explosives live on air. Fito was arrested in 2011 and sentenced to 34 years for organized crime, drug trafficking, extortion, and murder. His rise to the top of Los Choneros followed the assassination of the previous leader, Jorge Luis Zambrano, alias Rasquinha, in 2020. Despite being imprisoned, Fito allegedly continued to run his criminal operations, including drug trafficking, with some level of preferential treatment reported within the prison system. The assassination of Jose Luis Zambrano, Rasquinha, marked the beginning of a conflict within the criminal groups, leading to a refusal to accept the new leadership of Los Choneros under Fito and Junior Roldan, alias JR. This internal strife led to the fragmentation of Los Choneros into four subgroups: Los Choni Killers, Los Lobos, Los Pipos, and Los Tiguerones, none of which aligned with Fito and JR. They were involved in a power struggle that sparked violence in the nation's prisons, resulting in a series of massacres that claimed the lives of approximately 460 prisoners between 2021 and 2022. Fito appeared in a video announcing a peace pact. As law enforcement conducted operations in the Penitenciaria del Litoral, Fito held a mock press conference in the nearby regional Del Guayas jail to make his announcement. In the video, Fito stated, "Today, Tuesday, July 25th, 2023, I, Adolfo Macias, in light of recent events in our country, feel morally obligated to act responsibly towards our Ecuadorian fellow citizens and reach a peace and tranquility agreement with Los Lobos, Tiguerones, Fatales, Choneros, Ben 10, Latin King, M18, R7, agreeing to end extortion, forced payments, la vacuna, and violent deaths, to achieve better coexistence and security in Ecuadorian territory in conjunction with the national police." Following this announcement, two more videos were released, one by Los Tiguerones and another by Los Lobos, both groups accepting a ceasefire. A report by Primicias highlighted that at least 13 criminal groups, including former allies, now aim to eliminate Los Choneros and Fito, who remain the sole leader after JR's assassination in Colombia in May 2023. This has left Los Choneros vulnerable, with internal power struggles further complicating their operational funding and stability. While it seemed that Fito was serving time for his crimes, he was living a life of luxury within the prison walls, transforming his cell into a personal retreat. Fito's lavish lifestyle included a private bathroom, a hot shower, a cabinet, and a refrigerator stocked with cool beverages. His cell was equipped with a television featuring satellite TV and internet access, adorned with personalized art paintings. The extravagance didn't stop there. Fito celebrated his birthday with grandeur, complete with fireworks, in the prison's newly renovated nightclub, enjoying exclusive amenities that most wouldn't dream of in a correctional facility. Moreover, Fito had access to cell phones and other electronic devices. This privilege indicates the involvement and collaboration of corrupt prison authorities in facilitating such luxuries for an inmate. It's genuinely remarkable how Fito led a carefree life within the confines of prison for such an extended period. Even more surprising is that his extravagant lifestyle could have remained hidden without the intervention of 4,000 military officers who meticulously inspected the prison cells. Imagine Fito transforming a detention center into a luxury haven, akin to what you'd see in a high-end magazine. And the guards, how audacious they must have been to accept bribes from inmates, looking the other way as inmates brought contraband and luxury items were smuggled in. The audacity of it all is simply astounding. After Villavicencio's murder, Fito was transferred to La Roca, a maximum security prison, but a judge annulled that order and ruled that he should be returned to the regional jail. On Sunday, January 8, 2024, he was to be transferred to a maximum security facility known as La Roca, also located in Guayaquil, as part of President Daniel Noboa's new penitentiary policy. But when the military personnel entered the prison, Fito was nowhere to be found. He had escaped. The last time Fito was seen in public was in September of 2023, days after the assassination of presidential candidate Fernando Villavicencio, who had denounced before his death that Macias was threatening him. In photographs distributed by the police, he was seen as obese, with long hair and a prominent beard. Before Fito's escape, President Noboa had announced that he would build two maximum security prisons similar to the one built by President Nayib Bukele in El Salvador for gang members. Fito had already escaped from jail once before. In 2013, along with other inmates, he managed to evade the controls of the maximum security prison La Roca, but was recaptured after 3 months. They had escaped by navigating in a boat along the Dal River, which runs parallel to the prison. Meanwhile, the prosecutor's office has charged two correctional officers who were linked to Macias's escape. The government is offering a $100,000 reward for tips on Fito's whereabouts, hinting they need his interior decorating skills and five-star cell suite expertise back behind bars. Thanks for coming along on this eye-opener about prisons worldwide, especially those plush ones in Ecuador where Fito lived it up. What do you think about all this? Drop your thoughts below. If you found this interesting, hit the like button and subscribe for deeper insights into true crime stories. Thanks a lot for watching.